Hello everyone, how are you? I hope you all are fine and doing good. This is Mary Fatima here. So welcome back to your computer online session of class 3rd. In this video, I'm going to give you revision of lesson number 1 as your unit tests are very near. Okay, all of you? So please take out your books. So students, in your first unit, lesson number 1 and 2 will come. Again, I'm telling you, in your first unit test, lesson number 1 and 2 will come. Okay, and your test paper will be of 40 marks. Okay, and 50% will be from inside the chapter and 50% will be from your book exercise. Okay, again, I'm repeating that your test paper will be of 40 marks and 50% will come from inside the chapter and 50% questions will come from the exercise. Okay, all of you. So let's get started with the revision of lesson number 1. So please open page number 5. Okay, so this is your lesson number 1 and the name of the lesson is A Computer System. The name of the lesson is A Computer System. So in this lesson, we are going to learn introduction, functions of a computer, computer and its parts, kinds of output, types of hardware, hardware equipment functioning, and IPO cycle. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to give you the introduction of this. So what is a computer system? And what is a computer? A computer is an electronic machine that is used to generate information from data. It can store, organize data, and control other machines. Okay, student. So, a computer is an electronic machine that is used to generate information. Okay, and here are some of the parts of the computer. As you can see, monitor, keyboard, CPU and UPS. About these parts also, we are going to discuss in this chapter. Okay, all of you, please turn your page. Coming to the next page, we will start with functions of computer. So what are the functions of computer? So there are various functions that be performed by a computer. These are entering the data, processing the data, data storage and output of data processing. So how the computer is entering data? We can enter data with the help of input devices such as keyboard, mouse, etc. Okay, all of you knows it na, that with the help of input devices we can input our data. Okay, students, like if we want to do any typing, we can use keyboard and with the help of the keyboard we can insert our alphabets, right? Next function of computer, processing the data. We can process the data. That means it performs the calculations and comparison. And it is done with the help of CPU because CPU is the brain of the computer. Right? So it does all this. Now next function, data storage. It stores your data. Okay, computer memory store your data. And these are two storage devices, floppy disk and pen drive. Okay, and the last function is output of data processing. That means it gives you the result. Okay, the result is produced by the computer. Okay, now next we are going to start with computer and its part. So basically there are two parts of computer, hardware as well as software. Computer is divided into hardware and software. So all the physical parts of a computer that can be felt and touched are collectively called hardware. Okay, and some of the hardware parts are monitor, CPU, and we are having some other parts on the next page also. First of all, let me tell you about monitor. Monitor is also known the visual display unit. Means this one, the screen of your computer. This is known as VDU also, visual display unit. Okay, because it is displaying your visual effects. Okay, it works as both as input and output device. It shows what the computer is doing. So all of you knows very well. Now whatever the work computer is doing, we can see on this video. Okay. Next we are having this CPU. Central Processing Unit. So all of you knows very well about it, na? Because it is called brain of a computer. All of you have studied in first standard also, as well as in second standard also, that CPU is the brain of the computer. And the full form of CPU is Central Processing Unit, and it does all the calculations and comparisons. Okay, now come on the next page. So the CPU has three units. The CPU has three units: control units, arithmetic logic unit, and memory unit. As you can see in the picture here, this is the picture of CPU. Okay. So here this is control unit, this is arithmetic logic unit, and this is memory unit. So control unit controls all the functions of the computer, and all the calculations are being done in this ALU, and memory unit stores your data. Okay, so the next part is keyboard. So keyboard is an input device. It helps of keys we are able it helps us to enter data. With the help of keys, we are able to type the input. About 105 keys are present on the keyboard. All of you knows about this, na? That keyboard is having 105 keys. Okay. QWERTY keys or in some other manner. Okay. And keyboard is a input device. Next part which we are going to discuss is mouse. So mouse is a handheld device. We can hold the mouse into our hands. Okay. And mouse helps us to move the pointer on the screen. It helps us to select the required option on the screen, draw pictures, and do many other things. With the help of mouse, we can draw pictures, we can play games, and we can do other things as well. The next one is printer. Printer is an output device. It is used to print the output on a paper. All of you knows about this, na? This is the picture of the printer, and here in this printer machine we'll enter the paper. Then afterwards the paper will come from this upside when we will give command to our computer. And this is keyboard. This one is mouse. Next, software. So what is a software? Software are programs used to operate the computer. Okay, every computer needs a software, and the software are also of two types: application software as well as system software. That we will discuss in next chapter in brief. Okay, now all of you please turn your page. Next we are having kinds of output. Kinds of output. So there are two kinds of output: soft copy as well as hard copy. So first of all, I'm going to tell you what is a soft copy. It means the information which appears on the computer screen and can be stored in a hard disk, a CD, a pen drive, etc. Okay, so whatever the information you need, that can be stored in your hard disk as well as in a CD or in a pen drive. That form is known as soft copy. Okay, the information which is stored in a pen drive or CD, that form is known as a soft copy. And hard copy means the output which is printed on paper. Like I'll give you the example of your book. This is also a hard copy. And if I'll collect all the matter of the book in a CD or pen drive, that will be known as soft copy output. Okay, the next we are going to discuss is hardware equipment functioning. Hardware equipment functioning. So all the electronic and machinery parts related to the computer are collectively called hardware. As I told you, that hardware can be seen as well as can be touched. It refers to the parts of a computer system that you can touch and feel. Okay, so these are some of the hardware parts: monitor, CPU, hard disk, printer, keyboard, and mouse. Okay. So one by one we will discuss about these types of hardwares. First of all, I'll tell you monitor. Monitor we have discussed just before. That monitor is an output device. It is also known as visual display unit. As you can see, here is a picture of monitor. It shows the work done by the computer. Result shown by it is called soft copy. Okay, now come to your next page. Keyboard. Keyboard also, I told you that keyboard is used to input your work in a computer, and it has 105 keys. Okay, and there are alphabet keys as well as number keys as well as arrow keys. Different keys are present on the keyboard. Now next we are having this mouse. Next we are having this mouse. So mouse is a part of a computer that we move and click to do things on a computer screen, and we do different works with the help of mouse. We can draw pictures, we can play games. Okay. Next we are having this joystick. Here is a picture used made of joystick. So what is a joystick? So joystick is a device used to play games on the computer. It detects movement in two direction. It has got a stick to give signals. Like, I'll give you an example of car racing game. If I'll pick car racing game on my computer screen, then if I'll use this joystick, if I'll move joystick to the right hand side, my car will move to the right hand side, and if I'll move joystick to the left hand side, my car will move to the left hand side. So joystick is a device used to play games. The next one we are having is a scanner. So here you can see, this is a scanner. It is just similar to a photocopy machine. So what is a scanner? Scanner is used to scan pictures, photos, images into the computer, and it converts hard copy into soft copy. Like if I'm going to convert a paper into my computer, I'm going to enter the data of that paper, I will use this scanner, and this scanner will convert hard copy into soft copy. The next one is printer. All of you can see the picture of printer is being made here. So it makes a permanent copy of the processed information on paper, or printer is used to print the paper or the work done by a computer. Okay, now coming to the next. Last topic we are having our IPO cycle. Last topic we are having IPO cycle. So what is IPO cycle? First of all, let me tell you all that the full form of IPO is input process output. Input process output. In IPO cycle, the computer accepts the data as input, then processes it, and then provides the required output. Okay, as I'll give you an example here in your book also. An example is here. First of all, input is given, like entering the data, like 7 plus 8. Then 7 plus 8 is being processed. So this is doing the processing of the entered data. Then output. Output means the result. So 7 plus 8 equals to 15. So this is the output or result given by the computer. So this is the work of the IPO cycle. Input, process, and then output. So student, this was the explanation of your chapter. I hope you have understood each and everything, whatever I have explained you. And please one more time go through with the video, just because multiple choice questions are going to come in your unit test. Okay, now I'm going to explain you the question answers as well. So all of you please open page number 11. So first question, how do you define a computer? How do you define a computer? So a computer is an electronic machine that can store, organize, and find information and do calculations. The answers are already written in your fair copy. Number two, name the various parts of a computer. So computer has various parts like monitor, CPU, keyboard, mouse, etc. Right. Now next, what is hardware and software? So I told you that hardware are the machinery and electronics part of a computer, and software are programs used to operate the computer. Right. Now question number four, what are the main functions of the computer? So what are the main functions of the computer? It is on page number 6, entering the data, processing the data, data storage, and output of data processing. Question number 5, name the various parts of computer hardware. So what are the various parts of computer hardware? Monitor, keyboard, mouse, joystick. Okay. Now the last question, what is IPO cycle? Just now I have explained you that IPO cycle. In IPO cycle, the computer accepts data as input, processes it, and provides the required output. And the full form of IPO is input process and output. Okay. So students, you have to learn all these things very carefully. Okay, now turn your page number 12. We are having multiple choice question first. So I'll read for you one by one. A computer is a dash machine. So what is a computer? It is an electronic machine. So the answer is electronic, just because it runs with the help of electricity. Number two, CPU is the dash of a computer. So what is the CPU? CPU is the brain of computer because it does all the calculations and comparison. And CPU has three units, memory unit, control unit, and ALU. Okay. Now, number three, a keyboard has about dash keys on it. So it has 105 keys on it, right? Alphabet keys, number keys, arrow keys, enter keys. Okay. Now, function keys. Now, number four, dash has got a stick to give signals. So, joystick. And I told you that it is a device used to play games. Okay. The last thing which we are going to discuss today is fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks. So, number one, dash is used to move things on a computer screen. So, what is used to move? Mouse. With the help of mouse, we can move the things on the computer screen because it is a handheld device. And it is used to draw pictures and to do different works. Number two, dash is used to input our work. So, which is used to input our work? A keyboard. Keyboard is used to input our work because it is an input device. It is used to enter our data, right? Then number three, dash is processed by the CPU. So what is processed by the CPU? Data. Data is processed by the CPU. And the last one, dash is an output device. So printer. Printer is an output device. There are a lot of output devices, but here in your answers, printer is given. So we have to write down printer here. Okay, student. So I hope the chapter is very clear to you as well as the book work. Now homework is there for you. What is the homework? That you have to learn the chapter, question answers as well as book work. And one more time you have to go through with the video and please read the chapter again by yourself. That will help you to understand the meaning of the chapter clearly. Okay, in the next video I'll come up with the revision of lesson number 2. Till then, all of you stay home, stay safe, take care and enjoy.